Okay, hello all. I'm Felder and welcome to this Let's Play Empire Total War Venice series with Darth mod. I'll try to upload an episode every other day and I'll be happy to read any comments or suggestions you might have about the campaign. I've had this somewhat of a flu for the last 2 weeks, so sorry for any coughing sounds you might hear from coming from here. I'll try to mute the mic if any sudden coughing attacks comes, but I might not be able to make it in time, so apologies ahead of time. For the difficulty settings, I usually play, this is my usual settings, campaign difficulty hard, battle difficulty normal. This is because this makes the AI more aggressive in the campaign map, but in the battle map it I don't find that it's useful to use the hard mode because or hard setting because what it does it really doesn't make the AI any more intelligent or make good decisions in the battle. It mainly just makes your guys poor aimers. So you just can't hit the AI troops. So the normal is basically a good setting to use in the battle difficulty. for the victory conditions, I always use the world domination. Short campaign, not worth it. Only 50 years to use. Long campaign, you have pretty strict rules which you need to or regions you need to conquer to fulfill the victory conditions. Also, prestige victory doesn't really matter. I don't think I have used this at some point, but I don't remember if I finished the game at all. Basically, world domination is best because it's just 35 regions for Venice you need to control. Doesn't matter which ones, so you are free to wage war with any nation you wish and conquer them. Just reach the 35 regions and you have won. The same, I think, goes for the AI. The AI is not focused on certain regions, but are free to attack and basically pursue the victory conditions kind of freely, I guess. Also, I'm currently using my hard disk to record this video, so I really can't talk at the same time as the game is loading up something because it'll cut my mic off and create all sorts of video problems. So I'll be cutting most of the loading screens from this video. I will, of course, show you the campaign moves of the AI side, but I'll just shut up while the AI is doing its moves. So, with that said, let's dive into it and I'll see you on the campaign map. And welcome back. Here we are. I already did a little scouting trip across the map here. So we own Venice and Patras Morea in what today would be Greece, I guess. So I think that if we are going to keep this Morea region here, then the Ottomans will attack us like right away. And the other thing is that we have neighbors like Spain who will probably attack us as well. Though they are friendly with us. So maybe we can deal with them sometime later. Yeah, let's sell this Morea region to, I think to the Russians, if they want it. It's sort of an easy way, I think, to get the Russians and the Ottomans to fight each other and not butter like Austria or myself anytime soon. I think we can make Austria our ally. Maybe. Yeah, let's see what happens. Russia. Regions Morea. And payments. What should I ask for it? Let's try 10,000. That's a bit long shot, but we can come down off always. No. No, I don't want commie. No. Try it again. Let's try 7,000. About 5,000. Yay. Great. Okay, what else? So our army is over here right now.
Cittadini, in marcia.
We do have one village which we could turn into school, but Italian states have this Jesuit college which would suit better as a school, but then again we would need to attack Italian states first and finish them off. Dragoons, demi-cannons. Okay, so surprisingly, Italian states have much. Oops. They have much slightly stronger force than we do. one line infantry, two pikemen and militia with dragoons. And we have militia. Okay. Actually, we might be able to finish them in a couple of turns. I believe yeah, they don't have any allies either. And this might be a great opportunity to kill them off. Yeah, let's start this campaign off with a bang. I'm just gonna save the game quickly. And then we will attack. Let's declare war first. Yeah, no need to call non-existent allies. I'm a bit excited.
Yeah, totally.
And I'm gonna fight this battle in the battle map, and I'll see you in a bit. Alright, if I lose this battle, it might be game over very soon, so let's hope for the best. I usually just get rid of the demi cannons in the beginning of the game, because they are basically useless. They are large bore, so very they hit with a force, but basically they usually don't hit anything. They are very inaccurate guns, and they cost a lot to upkeep also, so it's I find it's usually better just to get rid of them as soon as possible. But right now it's good to have them in the army just to menace the enemy in the beginning at least. I'll have the pikemen on the flanks, and my militia in the center. That might not be very good idea usually, but in this case, I think it's useful. I don't really need to protect the demi cannons, so I'll just hide my general in the woods and maybe spread out my cavalry a bit so I can flank or attack the enemy demi cannons in the beginning. I'll probably actually use the provincial cavalry, oh sorry, regiment of horse to attack the demi cannons. Okay, let's start. And okay, forget about that. the pikemen don't really like to run. They get exhausted pretty fast. Oh, also, I'm using the debug camera just so that I can view the battlefield from high up and get a better understanding of the situation. Yeah, keep going. We have the pipeman there. It seems I don't have to attack. Ooh, nice shot. So, it seems our demi cannons can hit something. Something I usually don't see other players, at least in the videos, use is if you choose your cannon and press Control and right click on the ground, you can target a spot. That's spot on the battlefield. You don't need to target the enemy unit. It's very useful, especially in case, because if you target an enemy unit by right-clicking, it tends to target some last guy on the far end of the unit. Artillery won't really hit the center of the unit, but the end. What's happening? Provincial line infantry is behind that fence, and so I don't need or I don't want to take my pikemen too close to them. But they need to secure the left flank there. Dragoons are coming. Kill them! Kill them all! Oh my god. Pikemen are. My pikemen are faltering. Let's attack them in the flank. Where are you going? That's the dragoons gone. Here come the line infantry. Where are you people going? The enemy is that way. What? general is dead. Yep. Pikemen are running away. Let's get the other pikemen over here. Okay. That's about it. Yeah, I'm gonna try and kill as many of the enemy units as possible. What is wrong with this cavalry? There must be something with the terrain or something causing this pathfinding issues. But this was very good start for the campaign, I believe. Because now we can... Okay, that's 20 left. Okay, this is a little bit more, so let's kill them. Kill them all. I don't have any music playing during this gameplay or Let's Play series at all, because Darth mod included, while it's very good music and very appropriate, but it's also copyrighted material, a lot of it. Music from movies and such. So YouTube rules really restrict using from the music in the mod. If you wanna upload any videos, Let's Play videos of Darth mod, you need to kill off the music. That's enough. Just run them off. Close victory. I don't think so. Okay, but I'll see you in the campaign map. And here we are. We lost 624 and have almost 2000 remaining. They lost almost 1900 men. And pikemen had most kills. Nice. Okay. So, they have 75 remaining, probably.
Pronti!
Okay.
In marcia!
They didn't die off straight away. Let's
Preparatevi alla
kill them.
guerra!
No need to. The thing is, I don't really trust the auto-resolve. It usually comes up with terrible losses against small force, enemy force like this. So I'll fight it out and let's see the battle results. Okay, that was the fight. The enemy demi cannon managed to get one shot off and killed five of my men, but otherwise it was okay.
Issate la bandiera!
There. We can't really advance further on this turn, but I think we can take Rome on the next one. So my plan here is to unify Italy as fast as possible. I think Spain will attack me in any case very soon. So we don't necessarily need to attack Spain. They will attack us. Or rather, maybe Genoa is going to attack us as soon as we conquer Rome. But right now, let's see if we can get any allies or trade agreements going. France is allied to Spain. The Marathas usually get conquered by Mughals very, very early in this game, so I tend to avoid trade agreements with them. Same thing goes with the Mughals, because while the Marathas are getting invaded by the Mughals, the Mughals' trade ports will be blockaded by Marathas, so it's kind of pointless to make lasting trade agreements with them, at least until the Mughal Empire has conquered all of the India. 13 colonies instead is a great trade partner. They usually last very long because they're the protectorate of the British. So that was easy. Let's see if we can make allies of the Austrians. Oh, glorious day. Great. That was easy. Almost too easy. Yeah, that's about all we can do in the diplomacy. How about our policies? They are fine. Everyone is happy. Can we improve? Oh, what is this glitch? Never seen that before. Well, President is not that good. Oh, Premier. Oh, yes, we are a republic. Let's see who is. Oh, he's honest. Honest reputation. Jughead. He would be great justice administrate. Oh, it's the opposition. Oh, I'm so used to playing as a monarchy or yeah, basically the monarchy. you can just change your cabinet however you choose. But now that I'm a republic or a democracy, I can only kick someone from the... Okay, these are not bad. They're not terrible. I might try and change this guy and hope for the best. Oh, no. Fine. And you only get one chance to do that. Can I drag? Oh, yeah. Okay. So I can drag this around. Okay, he's a patron. Let's try to swap this. Well, little bit better. And he's honest status quo, stallholder, harsh reputation, agrarian. We don't have that big of an army, so these bonuses don't really affect us very much. Let's swap these around. Yeah. Because the plus two per turn to town wealth and home theater and prestige and diplomatic relations, that's in my opinion, it's more important than the minus 2% recruitment cost or whatever the army guy gives us. How about the trade? We aren't doing that much trade, but we might try and improve on that. But we have lots of money, so let's spend some. And I believe we have two navies, of which this one is completely useless. And still the upkeep is very high. Gonna place them here because we need to... Okay, let's keep this for now. Because we need to protect our trade.
Si, signore.
From the Barbary coast or Barbary states, they will try, if they can, they will try and blockade me. I guess we could at the same time raid the Italian state trade route and get some more money at the same time. Alright, we still have some money, so I will recruit a conscript, one of them. Oops, that's mine. And 1/5 rate. After all, I'm Venice. I'm playing Venice, so I need to have a strong navy in order to control the Mediterranean region at least. And at the same time, I need to send out trade fleets to the trade nodes and theaters. So let's see what happens on the end of turn, and let the AI play along. We don't have any college to check the technology. We've done all we can here and all we can here. Of course, ooh, roads, it's fine. I'll do it later. But right now, let's end turn and see what happens. I'm gonna shut up for the AI turn because, like I told you, I'm recording this on my hard drive, and while it's doing stuff like writing and reading during the AI turn, it tends to cut my recording, at least for the voice recording. So my blathering would be broken up anyway if I continued it. So let's see what happens. No. These people are desperate. Okay, that wasn't so bad. United Provinces, Spain, Russia, Poland, Lithuania, Karata Confederation, Portugal, and unit recruited. Can I get my army? Yes, I can. Let's save the game. And I think I'll just go in. I can't see what they have in there,
Preparatevi alla guerra!
Let's get the conscripts over
In
here.
avanti per il paese e la corona! Signore, donate la carica!
Oh, mortars and line infantry and firelocked armed citizenry. Okay, let's continue
Assedio
the
in
siege.
corso!
Can I get the AI? I can. Another one. And then a couple of roads. Need to wait for the fifth rate to get finished. I don't know who came up with it or where I picked it up. Anyway, I need to put there's a bug in this game that makes the Ottomans to take ages for their turn. The farther this game progresses, so placing a fleet here will basically undo that bug, let's say. I guess it has something to do with this crossing. The same bug appears with Sweden sometimes, and they also have this crossing here. I haven't seen the bug with the American theater because they do have crossings here, but I never seen Iroquois or any of the American nations to produce the turn lag bug. But there's very little we can do in the beginning of the game because we lack the money. So let's just see what happens on the end of turn. They probably attack me, but I'll just have to defend myself. I'm kind of hesitant to do this, to make alliance with the Russians because they are very close to Austria and might get into conflict with them, also with the Ottomans. So I think. Hold on. Aren't we supposed to be allies with Austrians? They are already at war with Prussia, Ottoman Empire, and Sweden, so sure. I knew it. Yeah, let's defend ourselves, and I'll meet you in the battle map. And here we are. I didn't realize they have a fort, which is another good reason not to attack them because we don't have the force necessary to take it, I believe. I'm gonna use a little bit of a gamey strategy here, or tactic, because as long as they lose this fight and or basically, I win it if they can't drive me off. I will win the siege at some point. So I really don't need to go after them. They are going to come after me. So I will just seek out the best possible place to defend myself. and let them run around the map. Gonna put the pikemen on the flank here. And the other larger pikemen force here, and this will, this can be like some sort of reinforcement. Let's get the cavalry back here. So one reason to deploy your troops far away from the enemy fort is so that their mortars can't reach us. So they will have to send all the mortar, or they usually send all the mortar crews out of the castle and attack with them straight on. Okay. Oh, right, we have a cannon here. Let's place it. It's an uphill fight for us. So the enemy will have the high ground, but I don't care. Let's put it on the right flank. Somewhere over there. Little further back. There. And you can fire whenever you like and whatever you want. Like I said, the demi cannon is pretty much useless anyway. Okay, let's start the fight. I'll just fix these positions a bit. Ranged units. Yeah, like I said, this is a little bit gamey tactic, but if you think about it, they are attacking me. Why should I attack them? They will lose if they stay in the fort. They will lose anyway. So as in real life, why would you go kill yourself? Or have yourself killed without purpose. So let's just keep back and defend ourselves and organize our troops as efficiently as we can. By that I mean by extending our battle line until up to the edge of the battle map, basically assures that the enemy cannot outflank me. They will have to come head on. That might be the most gamey thing about this deployment. But there are also so many reasons why I don't think anyone should have bad feelings about using these kind of tactics. In real warfare, you have so many other tactics you can use that are not available to us in this game. That I don't think it's wrong to use whatever means you need to win. Okay, let's speed the game up and just wait for the enemy to come to us. This is because of the debug camera. With the effects, it sometimes does this kind of box around it. If I we're any closer, it's not an issue. Let's use the demi cannon for something more productive. Like right there. Somewhat useless, these mortar crews. Just run away, all of you. It's really raining. Ooh, some of them actually reach our line. It's so rare that I use these forces that I don't even know what that this does. Bike formation. What happens? Okay, great. I guess we can use it here as well. I guess it's somewhat a defensive stance for this unit. So I'm targeting the demi cannon just a bit ahead of the enemy forces. Check this. Okay, stop firing. Otherwise, we will kill our own troops. Don't want that to happen. We can't fire the demi cannons until the enemy is on top of this ridge. I don't think even then. Maybe we can shoot a couple of more times. Right there. That was close. Yeah, no use. Give them a blast from the demi cannons. No, we cannot. Is there any better spot on the battlefield? Not really. No. Fine. Basically, all I need to do is to hold the line. they are actually coming into a melee. What is wrong with the AI? They're not even running. Let's attack with our pikemen from... Do we need to? I don't think we need to. The line infantry might be easier to win with these melee units. And they're already running away. Not going fair well for the AI. Get back here. Yeah, run. Shoot them in the back. These guys will probably come back, I don't know. Let's see, yeah. At least some of them. But since they're already broken once, it's unlikely they will last for... I don't like this weather. Bad luck. You're gonna shoot your own people. I can see the musket smoke creates some lag when I'm near it. I usually play the Darth mod 40 unit saves. But for the miners, I think it's easier to use the normal 20 unit armies because when you're playing a miner, you might not have the economy to upkeep a full 40 unit stack, so you can get very easily overrun by the major AI nations, because they will field multiple 40 unit stacks easily. Mortars are running away finally. Only enemy units I'm really worried about are these line infantries. But they have already suffered some losses and ran away at least once already. So not that worried. scripts have also had like 70, about 65 casualties. Same here. None with the pikemen. The militia. 30. That's not bad. Not bad at all, I think. I'm gonna take you off from the formation. And you run there and attack these guys. Then I'll take the heavy cavalry unit over here. Run. Regiment of horse as well. Let's see how many enemy forces we can kill off before they run off map. Signor C. I guess that's like, yes sir, in Italian. Regiment of horse can attack these guys. Now we'll have troops stop firing, so we can bring our heavy cavalry over here and attack the line infantry. Hunt them down. No. Let's use our general as well. We need to make it a little more compact like that. Please kill them. I think the cavalry should be much faster in this game. It's annoying how slow these guys are. They still have one mortar unit here. Let's go kill them first, so then they don't shoot our cavalry. Oh, there it comes. Kind of short range, I think. I'm gonna continue a bit. Let's speed things up. Kill all of these. Kill them all. Yep. And continue with these guys. And they manage to get off the map. Dang it. Yeah. That's all. Yep. Okay. Let's see what happens. Yeah, good result, of course. Conscripts made good progress there. So we get to have some naval battle in this episode as well. But I guess this is so small battle that I'm just gonna go and kill these guys off, and we'll just check the battle results. Yes, so couple of broadsides and instant surrender. Fairly easy. I think I will just take the prize money. So I believe I don't need to press anything or do anything. Just accept and get the money. Yeah. Okay, let's see to the end of this turn. Let's do our stuff and let's see what happens with Rome. I'm gonna move my fifth rate to the fleet and take my at least one of my conscripts. Let's take both of them over to the army and we'll recruit some more conscripts. They are a little bit better than regular militia. At least accuracy is 10 points better, and so it seems our 6-11-6-4-9-4. So better melee, better morale. We already did that. We have one gentleman, we don't have a school. We are improving basically all we can. So all we need to do is take Rome. I am going to recruit another fifth rate. I would recruit also brigs and sloops, but I don't have any slots to recruit them in.
Ordini, capitano.
But I think we... I'm gonna throw these away, I think. Actually, let's place them here, because I don't really mind if I lose them. I'm gonna if no one attacks them before I can recruit some proper sloop force here, I don't mind if I lose them. I'm gonna disband them anyway. Just a waste of upkeep money, I think. They only have a couple of cannons facing straight forwards. Can't really do any damage to enemy. I feel like attacking them. Because they will not attack me anymore. They know they are going to lose. Okay, I'm gonna attack them and get back to you with the battle results. Alright. They managed to inflict some damage to my troops, but they had so many mortars in the fort. But we won. Yay. There. We have captured central Italy and destroyed a nation. Plus 2 the morale in battles. That's good because half of my troops just ran away from the fort. but no matter. I think that's enough for this episode. I will upload this one and we'll see in the next one. So if you have any comments or suggestions, I'm happy to read them and reply to any questions if you have any. If you like this video or this content, please leave a like or dislike if you don't like it. At least my English needs some practice, but this is good practice for that too. So that's about all. Let's wrap things up and I'll see you in the next episode. Bye bye.